Hi, I'm Randy Altig with Quick and Easy the Costco Way, and today I'm going to be making Alaska Cod Pachanga tacos. Now in Spanish, pachanga means party, so let's get this party started. I've measured out all of my spices to a half a teaspoon. So first we'll add in our smoked paprika. Mmm, smells so good. Our garlic powder, our onion powder, chili powder, and our ground coriander. And then we'll just take a spoon and we'll mix that up. And you can leave it in here to use onto your fish by placing it with your fingers, or you can put it into a shaker and we'll be shaking that on the fish a little bit later. So now onto our crema. We'll first add in our sour cream. I'll be adding in creme fraiche. Now traditionally, when you're making a crema, they'll be using mayonnaise, but I like to use the creme fraiche because it really elevates the texture. It makes it smooth and creamy and wonderful. We'll add in our lime juice, garlic, and then today I've decided we're gonna add in a little bit of lime zest. This really brightens up the flavor and rounds out the profile. So I'm adding in some sriracha, and then we'll put in a little bit of salt, and we'll mix this up. And once it's thoroughly mixed, we'll put it into our squeeze bottle. To balance out the flavor of all the spices, I've decided today to use a prepared coleslaw. Now you can make your own coleslaw at home if you'd like. And then to brighten that up a little bit, some sweetness, I'm adding in some diced pineapple. And then for some added crunch, some salted cashews. And just stir that up. We'll be adding this as a topping to our tacos once we start to assemble. So I've diced my avocados, our tomato, and grated the cheese, which we'll be using all for our toppings when we assemble our tacos once the fish has cooked to perfection. One of the great things about buying your Alaskan cod at Costco is it comes vacuum-packed, frozen, in a pre-cut 8-ounce serving for easy, uniform cooking. Now I've rinsed the cod fillets and I'm just patting them dry to get them ready for the rub. Next, let's generously coat our fillets with our melted butter. And then we will put on our wonderful pachanga spice rub. You know, one of the things that I really like about the Alaska cod is its versatility. And it's really wonderful in just about any recipe. Now let's flip our fillets so that we can butter and season the other side. Now here's a tip. If you're short on time, you can also cook these fillets frozen. You know, most Alaska seafood is flash frozen to maintain its highest quality, its maximum purity, and taste. I'm now ready to take the cod fillets and put them into the oven. It should be preheated to 375. I'm going to cook them for approximately 10 minutes, and then we'll turn the oven to broil and cook them for an additional 2 to 3 minutes. Now the temperature internally should be about 145. The fish is done, and now it's ready to be flaked. And then we will start assembling our tacos. Here's a tip for making the perfect taco. I like to use a taco rack. And you'll just take your tortilla, you put it in, add a little bit of my pachanga Alaska cod, some of our crema, and you can never get too much of this crema. Then we elevate that taste with our coleslaw, some tomatoes for just a little bit of color. Of course, avocados, another squirt of your crema. As I said, you can never get too much. And then we round out the top of it with a little coat of cheese. And here's your perfect pachanga taco.
Quick and easy, the Costco way.